Hi guys, welcome back to another devlog on my FPS online multiplayer game. This week we've been working on picking up and dropping weapons. I've added guns, I've got some recoil, and if we're making a multiplayer FPS, or even just an offline FPS, we need to be able to pick up or drop weapons when we see them on the ground. That's almost a universal ability found in FPS games, at least if there's a limit on the guns you can carry at any one time. For example, in Halo, you can only carry two weapons at any given time. In CSGO and Valorant, you have what I'm calling a primary and secondary weapon, where you can carry two weapons, but certain kinds of weapons like rifles and shotguns are reserved for the same slot, and you can't carry an AK and a sawn-off at the same time. This is the kind of behavior that I'm going for in my game, but it's early days and I can easily change it. The first challenge I came up against was deciding what to do when the player tries to drop a gun. In my case, that's the G key. My gun is just a spatial node with a mesh attached to it, so instancing a version of that would result in it just sitting in space and not doing anything, which is far from realistic. So what I tried to do first is have a physics body version of my weapon that I would instance when I hit the drop button and give it a bit of force to push it away from the player. That took a bit of work to get up and running at first, but I got it working in the end. But how do you pick it up once it's on the ground? First I thought, I need to give my guy hands, but then I remember that real world rules don't really apply here, so I slapped an area detection node on, and when the player passes through, we instance the gun back on the player. Not the fake one, but the real one. But by now I was getting kind of annoyed, as it meant I would need two objects for every gun. I would have to link both objects by code, and it meant twice as many scenes and a lot of link code, and it just meant more chances for bugs. I do realize this is the normal way that you do it, but I'm trying to cut a corner here, so I did the most sensible thing I could think of and turned my gun into a physics body, so I would just need to worry about one object. This resulted in no errors at all and was totally an easy and sensible thing to do. Jokes aside, I wasn't expecting to get away with this, but out of the box, when I parented the rigid body to the player, it was just fine. Which was eerily strange, like I expected it to just drop in place and fall to the ground, but it was fine. And I forgot about it for a while, but it kept nagging me in the back of my head, like, hey, this shouldn't work, and I noticed some strange anomalies when I released the gun from the player. The guns were flying off in strange directions. So I addressed this strange behavior by attempting to change the mode of the physics body to a static, which is where we get the sliding behavior from. This was really frustrating because I didn't want to leave it parented as a physics body. On closer inspection, I had noticed that the linear and angular velocity behaving strangely as well. My final attempt to solve the jank, as I'm calling it, was to change the body to static and turn off all collisions on the gun. This solved my sliding issue and stopped the velocity from behaving strangely. But at the core of these issues is that I'm trying to cut a corner by not having to keep two copies of each entity, a world one and player one, which is probably the norm for most games. I might have to change this later on, but for now it works well. Because the node on the gun is the same as the one on the ground, it makes it pretty easy. The reason I chose this approach is because I originally wanted to change the parent of the gun from the world to the player and save myself instancing the weapon. But it turns out that's not possible. At least I couldn't find a way to do it, so I still ended up having to instance a new gun on the player and delete the old one. So the only thing this really saves me is setting up the scene and keeping track of it. So cheating the system basically really didn't help me that much. Might change it since this is kind of jank. I also had to introduce a weapon handler script to keep track of the weapon slots. Right now I've set up a dictionary with four slots, one for primary, secondary, melee and throwing. Each slot can be occupied by one item. When the player picks up the weapon, it checks first to see if the slot is occupied. If it's free, a copy of whatever weapon is on the ground is instanced on the player, along with the ammo values, and the one on the ground is deleted. The visual information is also changed to suit my camera setup, and the collision mode on the rigid body is set to static and the collision layers are removed. If the weapon slot is occupied, the unique identifier or UID of the gun is returned to the gun on the ground, and it checks to see if the guns are the same. If they are, it will attempt to hand over any ammo to the player. If that reduces the ammo of the gun on the ground to zero, then it will be deleted as well, to avoid any confusing moments picking up weapons that have no ammo. If the weapon slot is occupied, but the UID is different from the gun on the ground, it notifies the player, and an option to swap is presented, which can be activated with the F key for now, which is different from the drop key, but making them the same requires a bit of tweaking, which I haven't gotten around to yet. Aside from the jankiness of the actual scene setup for all of this, I'm really happy with how it's working. It's kind of funny when you try and cut a corner and you end up costing you more time if you just did it properly. That being said, all of the code for this can stay the same if I ever decide to revert back to the normal way of doing things, but for now it's fine, and I don't think I will need to change it unless there's sort of visual limitations on this game, unless I need to do a high detailed gun for when the player's holding it and a low detail one for when it's on the ground. Right now everything's really low detail, so none of that really matters, but you know, we'll cross that road when we come to it. It's not a big deal. Anyway, that's all for this devlog. Make sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more of me trying to cobble together some excuse for a game. As always, the source is available on my itch. Thanks for watching. I'm Isaac, I am ChefDev, and I'll see you next time. I also had to introduce a weapon handler script to keep track of the weapon slops.